Hello there and welcome! Today's video will be all about Nenio and how to build her. Now, Nenio is certainly designed to be a very strong crowd control focused caster, capable of easily debilitating our enemies and even instantly killing them with her very powerful illusion spells. With this build, you will be able to achieve all of that and even get to attack the enemies with her from the mid to late game with a very special weapon designed just for wizards. So without further ado, let's get started on our Nenio build. Alright, so Nenio comes at level 3 and is actually a Scroll Savant wizard. Personally, I don't care much for this archetype. If it was up to me, I would certainly have made her something like Exploiter Wizard. But it can still be useful in Wrath of the Righteous, mostly because this time, unlike in Kingmaker, we can actually craft our own scrolls. Basically, one scroll per rest. The class is overall the same as Wizard, you have the same spellcasting progression. The main difference is that at level 5 you gain Scroll Specialization, which lets you calculate the difficulty class of any scroll you use based on your intelligence modifier, as by default scrolls tend to have a fixed caster level, and then at level 10 you gain Scroll Mastery, which lets you use your own caster level instead of the item caster level when using a scroll. Basically, for all those scrolls that you get during the game, if you have Nenio on your party, you will have the most optimal way of using them, as they will scale not only with Nenio's caster level, but also receive an increasing difficulty class. Nenio is actually also an illusionist, so she has the illusion school as her specialist school. This means that on every spell level she will have an extra favorite illusion school slot that she can only spend with an illusion spell. And on the other hand, she also has both the Abjuration and the Necromancy school as opposition schools. What this means is that she can actually still cast spells of those schools, but whenever slotting those spells, they will take two whole slots instead of just one. For example, even though I have 4 shields memorized here, each use will cost me 2 slots. With that out of the way, let's get started with our build progression. We'll increase Scroll Servant basically until level 10 for Scroll Mastery, and after that we'll enter into Lore Master. At level 4 we of course want to increase Intelligence, and this is what we increase until around level 16. As for skills, the ones Nenio starts with are good enough. Basically, all of the knowledge and lore skills, and later you'll also be able to increase Use Magic Device, so she can use scrolls from any classes, including divine spellcasters like clerics. And even those scrolls will also scale with her caster level, so she can provide quite powerful divine buffs for your party as well, and you can buy those from your cleric merchants. As far as your first spells for Nenio, be sure to go with both Grease and also Glitter Dust. These two spells are certainly by far the best crowd control spells you have during the early game, and can even scale decently into the mid to late game as well. As you might already know, they bypass spell resistance, so perfect for early game demons, and will inflict either knockdown or blind. Now, do remember that Nenio as a wizard can actually learn spells by scrying scrolls you find or buy, so you don't actually have to pick the spells I select here, at least not on level up. At level 5 we have our first feat, and for this one be sure to go with Heightened Spell. Nenio in this build will be mostly a crowd control caster focused on debuffing the enemy, buffing our party, or of course, instantly killing the enemy. And Heightened Spell helps a lot when it comes to that, as it is a way to increase not only the difficulty class of certain powerful debuffs, but also increase the number of castings you have of that spell, as you can get them on multiple spell levels and not just the original spell level. As for spells, if Nenio is your main arcane caster and buffer, then you certainly want Haste and then Heroism. If you already have a character that can cast Heroism, then pick Greater Magic Weapon. For more level 3 spells, Displacement for a 50% concealment, and also Blur for 20%. For a level 7 feat, go with Meta Magic and Persistent Spell. Now, Persistent Spell will basically force the enemy to roll their saving throws twice against your crowd control spells, so perfect for making sure they hit. It does have a level increase of +2, but at this point, for example, we can already persist the Glitter Dust spell, both for a +2 difficulty class increase, and also, of course, forcing the enemy to roll twice against the very powerful Blind effect. Later on, we will be able to apply this to her unique Instant Death spell, so even better. At level 7 we also have our first level 4 spells, and the main one is of course Phantasmal Killer, which is the first one of the only two instant death spells that you get. It has amazing synergy with Persistent Spell, because this spell actually requires the enemy to first save against will and then fortitude to actually be instant killed. And later on we will be able to get enough chances of making this work with 100% chance even on hard and unfair, from all the gear boosts we will get to our illusion spells difficulty class. Besides that, Greater Invisibility is also another great buff. Another intelligence point at level 8. For more level 3 spells, I would go with Stinking Cloud. Yes, it's true that demons are immune to this, but most of the enemy cultists and other non-demonic enemies aren't. To inflict the highly useful nauseated effect that makes enemies incapable of doing anything besides moving. Besides that, if you want Nanya to have some decent spell damage at the early levels, go with Scorching Ray, but personally, I would rather have her debuffing the enemy. At level 9, go with Skill Focus and Knowledge Arcana. The reason is that this is a prerequisite for the Lore Master Prestige class, which we will enter as soon as level 11. Now we also have our first level 5 spells. Be sure to pick Animal Growth if you use pets in your party, unless you already have a character capable of casting it like Amelia. Besides that, I would also go with Stone Skin Communal. Level 10 will be our final Scroll Savant level. And because our Nanya will also have decent difficulty class for conjuration spells, you can also go with the pit spells such as Hungry Pit, Acid Pit, Spiked Pit at level 3. Once again, remember, you can learn these spells way earlier by getting Nanya a scroll. Pit spells can be decent in that, like most of the conjuration spells, they bypass spell resistance and will swallow enemies down, as you reduce the number of enemies you fight during battle. But I personally prefer either Glitter Dust or Grease. Now, level 11 is when you first pick Lore Master, and this is also when I would pick Greater Spell Focus, Illusion. As you probably noticed, most of your time during the early game as Nanya will be spamming either Grease or Glitter Dust, which are conjuration spells. At this point in the game, however, we can already cast Phantasmal Killer, and this is why I pick Greater Spell Focus Illusion at this level. Remember that you can always heighten and also persist Phantasmal Killer for higher chances of it working on the enemy. And of course, now let's talk about the Lore Master class. It's actually a very unique prestige class in that you can gain a lot of feats for free without the necessary requirements. Just look at this, for example, as a combat feat. We can pretty much pick any feat in the game. Even feats that only fighters get access to, like Greater Weapon Specialization or the Precise Shot feat, without having to get Point Blank Shot first. Now, an interesting thing about this as well is that, at least so far as this video, you can even get the Trickster Mythic Path special critical feats that both increase your critical range further and also the critical multiplier at the last feat. I'm not sure if this is intended or an oversight. After all, you are basically bypassing a mythic path, so personally, I think this can change in a patch later on. And this is the reason that I won't be picking it now. So the one I like picking the earliest here is choose Wizard Feat and then Greater Spell Penetration. After all, as I mentioned before, at this point we will start using spells that actually need to pierce the enemy's spell penetration, like Phantasmal Killer. We also get our first level 6 spells. You certainly want Hellfire Ray for damage, as this is basically the best single target spell in the game, but it's only really going to get strong at level 15 and then 19. Besides that, Greater Heroism, unless you have another character capable of casting it like Ember or a Bard or Scald Mercenary. Now at level 6 we also have the unique Phantasmal Putrefaction spell. My main issue with this spell is that while it does have a powerful effect of making enemies sleep, this effect will only target the enemies after the second round you cast it. In the first round, all they take is 1d4 damage to their wisdom score. It's only after that that they actually become subject to the sleep effect. So frankly, I would once again much rather cast Phantasmal Killer, the Pit spells, Glitter Dust or Grease. From level 11 onwards, we'll just keep increasing Lore Master. Remember that by default the game automatically picks your highest class level, so Scroll Savant. So be sure to pick Lore Master instead. Another intelligence increase at level 12. As for more spells, you can go with Mind Fog. Even though we won't have boosts to enchantment with Spell Focus and so on, remember that Nanya will be able to apply the persistent spell to this, so the enemies will have to roll twice, and if they fail the save, take a massive minus 10 penalty on will saves. Besides that, the mass version of the animal buffs are always great picks, but remember, you can always leave them to Camellia or Sociel. Besides Cat's Grace, which they cannot get by default. Chains of Light can be a very powerful crowd control spell as well, as it's going to bypass spell resistance and attempt to paralyze the enemy. They will get a save every round after, but because they actually take a massive dexterity penalty while paralyzed, and this spell does target Reflex, chances are they will be doomed to fail the save on every round after. For a level 13 feat, I would go with Improved Initiative. The faster she can act, the faster we can either debuff the enemy or outright instantly kill them. Now at level 13 we also get another Lore Master bonus feat. And this is when I pick Rogue's Secret, and then you have a few different choices. My favorite one here is Improved Evasion, because with this feat, Nanya will always take at the very least half damage from enemies' spells that target Reflex. So with Improved Evasion, even if Nanya fails her saving throws, she will still take half damage only. Besides that, you can also pick Familiar and then the Hair Familiar to increase Nanyo's initiative even higher. Now as for our first level 7 spells, Legendary Proportions is of course one of the best buffs in the game, and remember that even though this has a material component cost of Dinosaur Bones, Nanyo can actually bypass this by just scribing the scrolls during rest. Besides that, Ice Body is a very powerful self-only buff that will make Nanyo immune to quite a lot of stuff, most importantly critical hits and ability score damage. Now you might wonder why we didn't pick any offensive spell at this level, but remember, because we have access to both Heightened and Persistent spell, we can simply increase the level of, let's say, Phantasmal Killer, Grease, Glitter Dust and so on, to slot them in our level 7 spells. For more level 7 spells at level 14, I actually like Echolocation for Nanyo, even though this is a personal only buff. It will let you bypass any concealment the enemy might have, and concealment will come into play when trying to hit the enemy with our Hellfire Rays. Besides that, the Firebrand spell can actually empower all of your party members, pets included, with an extra fire damage on every single hit, and this can help quite a lot when it comes to proccing the Elemental Barrage ability. At level 15, I would pick Bolster spell to increase the damage of our Hellfire Rays even further, and remember, starting from this level we will actually fire 2 whole rays per casting, for 30d6 damage minimum. At level 15 we also get another special lore master feat, and in this case I like going with combat feat and shatter defenses. Now you might wonder why the hell I'm picking this feat, and the reason is simple. Shatter defenses lets you basically target the enemy's armor class as if they were flat-footed, so long as they are shaken or frightened, and flat-footed enemies lose a massive amount of armor class. So this can help Nanyo hit her Hellfire Rays and even her normal attacks with a crossbow, for example. And do remember that at level 15, we also get the very powerful Frightful Aspect spell, which will automatically shake in any enemy around you without a save, so will work even on Unfair, for basically a permanent shaken effect. This way Nanyo will automatically apply Shatter defenses to all of her attacks. But as I said before, if you don't find picking the Trickster special feats to be a bug or an oversight, that you can also choose either the first improved critical, and this will increase our Hellfire Rays critical range to a maximum of 17 to 20, or the last of the Trickster special critical feats, which adds an extra critical multiplier to our Hellfire Rays, so for x4 instead of just x3. So the choice is up to you. I'll be going with Shatter defenses myself. You might have also noticed that I don't bother picking Precise Shot and Point Blank Shot, so Shatter defenses will also help hitting the mid to late game enemies, which tend to have a lot more armor class. As for our first level 8 spells, Frightful Aspect as I mentioned before, but remember, you can always leave this for someone like Sociel, who will be closer to the enemies. Even then, the aura does have a massive size of 30 feet, so even if Nanyo stays somewhat far away from the enemies in the backline, she will still probably be able to hit them with the shaken aura. Besides that, the Sea Mantle spell for a massive plus 8 bonus to Nanyo's armor class, another point in intelligence at level 16, and you also have some leftover skill points now. I'll go with something like Perception. Well, we can actually even pick something like Dragonkind 3 here to highly increase Nanyo's hit points and also armor class by basically turning her into a dragon, or the Rift of Ruin Pit spells for our level 17 feat, improved critical, and then Ray. So now our Ray spells will critical on a 19 to 20 instead of just 20. As for another secret, pick Fortitude to give Nanyo a plus 2 bonus. As a caster, her lowest saving throw is Fortitude. At level 17, we at last get our level 9 spells, and you certainly want Weird, which is basically an area of effect spell of Phantasmal Killer, so it will attempt to instantly kill all enemies in a massive 30-foot burst. Besides that, go with Heroic Invocation for a very powerful buff to your party, unless you have Ember or Darren, who can already cast it. For more level 9 spells, Fiery Body, which is basically an upgrade over Ice Body, and also Foresight, for a very powerful plus 2 insight to armor class of all our characters. At level 19 we have our last feat, and this one can be anything you want really. I suppose you could go with something like Selective Spell, and remember, you can actually trade a feat earlier such as Improved Initiative for Selective Spell instead. Selective Spell will basically make your spells that have friendly fire affect only the enemy, so it can be good for something like Sirocco, but I would personally have Nanyo spam either Grease, Glitter Dust, or the instant kill spells. Of course, the Toughness feat for more hit points. I'll actually pick Martial Weapons Proficiency here to show you that Nanyo can even become a decent attacker, and remember, you can also pick this at level 13 instead of Improved Initiative. As for your last secret, pick Reflex. After all, Will is already Nanyo's highest saving throw as a full caster. And your last level 9 spells can be anything, especially as you can just learn most of your spells through scrolls instead of level up. Now we are at level 20 at last, and at this level there isn't much of a point in increasing intelligence, so let us increase dexterity so we can get an extra +1 to her modifier. Alright, now let's talk about Nenyo's mythic progression. Your first ability should certainly be Abundant Casting to increase our Nenyo's slots. At mythic rank 2, go with Expanded Arsenal and then Conjuration. This way, all of the bonuses that we apply to Illusion will also apply to the Conjuration spell school. And as I said before, your early game as Nenyo will be mostly spent casting Conjuration spells. These spells also bypass spell resistance, which is why I'm not picking mythic spell penetration so early. At mythic rank 3, improved Abundant Casting. Now, mythic rank 4 is when I would actually pick mythic spell penetration. After all, by this point in the game, so at around level 10 to 11, is when we'll finally start to cast spells like Phantasmal Killer that actually have to penetrate the enemy's spell resistance. Your mythic level 5 choice is also simple, greater Abundant Casting. At mythic level 6, be sure to go with mythic spell focus and then illusion. Alright, so starting from mythic level 7, we have quite a few different choices. Master Shapeshifter is actually a very decent choice for a Kitsune like Nenyo, because whenever she changes into her human form, she will gain an untyped +4 bonus to all her physical abilities score, so Strength, Dexterity and Constitution. Besides that, you can pick Ascended Element and then Fire to spam our Hellfire Rays with even greater power. But remember, through the aid of the Devouring Lust metamagic rod, you can just convert all of the fire damage into Unholy. Besides that, you can get started on the Enduring Spells line, but at this point in the game, we already have quite a lot of caster level and many spell slots, so I don't find it needed for her. We have Last Stand, of course, so she can avoid death, but as a back row character, chances are she won't be getting attacked that much. And of course, Favorite Metamagic and Bolstered, to decrease the cost of our Bolster spells to 0 instead of +1. But honestly, my favorite pick at Mythic 7 is Master Shapeshifter for the synergy with the Kitsune race. For Mythic level 8, be sure to pick Mythic Improved Critical and then Ray. Now we are at Mythic level 9, which will be our last Mythic for all intents and purposes. And just like with Mythic level 7, the choice is up to you. Archmage Armor is a decent choice to highly increase Nenyo's armor class, and this is the one that I'm going to pick. Alright, so let's talk about Nenyo gear now. Because Nenyo is a difficulty class focused caster, a lot of these choices will be similar to what I have already talked about in my How to Debuff Enemies guide, where I properly explain how you can even defeat the Demon Lords with instant kill spells. Now, to get started, we have of course the Glass Amulet of Clarity for her amulet slot, because of the very powerful +2 increase to the DC of mind affecting spells we cast, and all of our instant kill spells are mind affecting. The armor slot is up to you, but I would recommend you go with Haramaki's, a type of armor that mages can actually wear. They won't interfere with spellcasting, and even give not only a +1 boost to armor class, but also come with certain unique effects. This one, for example, will increase Nenyo's saving throws by a +4 sacred bonus. And we also have the Deadly Rays Haramaki to help her hit enemies with ranged touch spells, such as the ever so overpowered Hellfire Ray. For the robe slot, we have a few different choices. If you are an Azathar or Aeon, then the best robe at the end game would be the Robe of Mephistopheles for the -4 penalty on enemy saving throws against Fear, Compulsion and Charm effects, and our instant kill effects are Fear effects. If you aren't one of these mythic paths, then for the early game you can certainly make do with the Robe of Inevitability for a +2 bonus on spell penetration, and later on the Robe of Determination for a +2 increase to our Fortitude difficulty class spells. For the bell slots, be sure to focus on bells that increase both Nenyo's dexterity and also constitution. But remember, from chapter 4 onwards, you will certainly want at least one of your melee party members with the Display of Power belt, as to give the enemies a -2 penalty on their will saving throws. For the glove slots, my favorite are the Twisted Temptation gloves, as they will increase the DC of all your enchantment spells by +2. Not only that, but whenever you cast a spell, the enemy will be hit with a -2 penalty on their will saving throws for 3 rounds, and this does not have a save, so perfect for stacking debuffs on the enemy. As for the boots slots, well, I have recently just found out the most powerful boots in the game are the Ronex Sacrifice boots, because they give a massive +8 to dexterity, and even increase the bonus of your haste spells to your armor class, attack rolls, and reflex saving throws. This is actually a Storyteller relic, and I will soon release a video on how you can get it, but basically it's from the Winter Sun area. As far as headband, Gnawing Magic is the best one for wizards and intelligent focused casters, because of the very unique -1 stacking penalty to saving throws whenever you hit the enemy with a spell, and this will stack to a maximum of +4. When it comes to goggles, go with Goggles of Mind Control. If you are using Nenyo, then you probably will get these goggles, as you can find them on her last dungeon quest. For cloaks, as usual, the highest cloaks of resistance you can find for saving throws. And when it comes to rings, one of your slots should certainly be the Magician's Ring for the +2 increase to DC against illusion spells. Besides that, I also enjoy Steady Finger to increase our ranged touch attack rolls. Now, when it comes to bracers, I would actually go with the lesser bracers of archery, and the reason is that by default Nanyo as a wizard cannot equip both. However, with these bracers, she will be able to equip them just fine. And speaking about weapons, let us talk about Nanyo weapons choice. Your main weapon should certainly be the quarterstaff of the War Mage that you can find in the Ivory Sanctum at Chapter 3, as it will increase the difficulty class of all your spells by a +2. Never mind the hefty +4 bonus to beat enemy spell resistance too. Now, you might have noticed in the beginning of the video, I talk about a special weapon that lets Nanyo fight even in melee, and in this case, it's the Death's Consonant Bardiche. You can find this from a Crusade Relic during Chapter 3. And I already have a video on the best Crusade Relics, which I will link down below and also here to the side. Now, the special part about this Bardiche is that it actually lets you use your intelligence modifier both when it comes to attack rolls and also damage. And this is why Nanyo gets a +14 to her attack rolls from her intelligence and also to damage. Now, of course, to get Nanyo to equip this, you will need the Martial Weapons Proficiency feat. In my build guide, I picked it only at level 19, but you can, of course, switch it earlier whenever you hit Chapter 3, so around level 10 to 11, and change one of these early feats here, such as Spell Focus Illusion and Improved Initiative for Martial Weapons Proficiency. Last but not least, we have Nanyo's quick slots, and in here are all of the very powerful items that will highly enhance her spellcasting. First, the Devouring Lust Metamagic Rod, as usual, that you can also get from a Crusade Relic during Chapter 3. The best part about this rod is that it will instantly maximize any spell of any level up to 6 times per day, and also change the damage type to Unholy, so perfect for Nanyo's Hellfire Ray, even though we don't have the Ascended Element Fire ability. After all of the damage will become fire. Besides that, the Grandmaster's Rod to both maximize and empower our Hellfire Rays. Now, for a character like Nanyo who uses Illusion Instant Death spells, this rod also serves another purpose, as it will allow our Phantasmal Killer and Weird Instant Kill spells to bypass the enemy's immunity to fear. Lastly, we have two Greater Quicken Metamagic Rods. This will let Nanyo cast her spells as swift actions, so she will be able to cast two of them per round. And I don't need to say that casting two Weirds, for example, or two Phantasmal Killers against a single enemy boss is an easy way of making sure they will die. I also picked the Old Grimoire here, just as a way to give Nanyo more low spell slots, and finding this is easy, just defeat the Ivory Sanctum boss at Chapter 3. Alright, so now I'm going to give you an example of what spells I picked for Nanyo, and this is also a guide on how to play as her during the early, mid and late levels. Now, for the early levels, you certainly want to simply spam Grease against all of the enemy packs that you find. It's an extremely powerful spell, and trust me, once you go Grease, you never go back. Besides that, be sure to use the Glitter Dust spell as well. Now, when it comes to other spells, I would focus on buffing spells such as Mage Armor for Nanyo and your pets, Hurricane Bow to increase her crossbow damage, Shield for defense, True Strike to ensure your attacks hit, and of course, Blur, Displacement, Greater Invisibility and so on, as I have already explained in my How to Get the Highest Defenses guide. On the early game, you can also use Scorching Ray for some decent single target damage, but I would personally prefer to debuff the enemy. Besides that, Haste, of course, and Greater Magic Weapon. The Heroism spell can be very useful too, but in my case, I often have a Scald Mercenary cast it for me instead. And you can use someone like Ember as well for it. Now, by the mid-game is when you finally get Phantasmal Killer, your first instant kill spell. So be sure to save this for difficult single enemies, especially bosses. And remember to always debuff them before casting this spell, as it does require 2 saving throws. Once again, for packs of enemies, you can still use heightened and persistent versions of both Glitter Dust and also Grease to increase the chances of them hitting and also their difficulty class. Decent mid-level buffs would be Animal Growth for your pets, Echolocation for Nanyo, Stone Skin Communal, and Greater Heroism. Now, at mid-game you also get Hellfire Ray, but ideally this only becomes truly good at level 15 when you get your Fire 2 Rays. Be sure to bolster it for higher damage, as for other good buffs, Legendary Proportions and Firebrand. Now, during the endgame you will of course want to basically spam heightened and persistent versions of Phantasmal Killer for single targets, and of course Weird, our ultimate instant kill spell. And since we're talking about a scroll savant, I might as well teach you how to scribe scrolls. Well, whenever resting, you will have the scroll scribing tab here. Pick Nenio or any other character of your choice. You can choose between Knowledge Arcana for arcane spells, or Lore Religion for divine spells. Then click Choose a Spell to scribe a scroll, and choose the scroll that you want to scribe. Now you will need the associated scroll scriber's kit to scribe the scrolls of each level. For example, I don't have the level 8 scroll scriber's kit here, so I cannot scribe level 8 scrolls. But the process is very simple. Let us pick legendary proportions. Now below here you will see click to downgrade, and you can actually choose which caster level your scroll will end up having. The D letter here means the amount of time it's going to take, so if it's 1, then a single rest will be enough to scribe the scroll. You might notice below here that scribing scrolls also actually costs a few components, and this is different from the actual material cost that some scrolls have. Legendary proportions, for example, costs a dinosaur bone to use, but when you scribe it, it will not cost anything so long as you use it from the scroll. Don't be afraid of scribing a lot of scrolls, because you will find a massive amount of these low-tier components. Well, so this was it for this year's last video. I hope you had fun with this Nenio build I prepared for you. Certainly will leave you amazed when you see her outright instantly healing even the Demon Lords. As usual, please comment down below if you have another way of building Nenio that you enjoy. Please remember to like the video and support the channel if you can. Thank you for watching and see you next time, friends, or in this case, next year. And Happy New Year, everyone!